and suggest almost 4.6 million properties are unmortgageable. Is that even a word?
So let's get in the mood for this. One of the discussions that is emerging is collapsing sales that were driven from pandemic demand. Now, there have been a particular set of circumstances from the pandemic-induced recession that has still managed to maintain a buoyant housing market. I won't cover that in mass detail here, but suffice to say, as you would imagine, a combination of fiscal stimulus, i.e. stamp breaks and furlough schemes, as well as low interest rates, have resulted in this. If you do fancy a little bit more detail on that, I'll link the videos in the description box. Now that some of those mechanisms are coming to an end, such as the stamp duty hiatus, which would mean buyers losing out on about £15,000 of savings, there are extreme delays and economic strain which are now causing much higher levels of sales falling through. So let's sprinkle some facts and look at the numbers. So the number of sales falling through has risen from 17% in July 2020 to 28% in December 2020. This means that 1 in 5 sales were falling through in the summer to 1 in 3 sales in winter. This excludes a peak in March 2020 at the first lockdown, when uncertainty caused a massive back out of sales as people were spooked. Anyway, December 2020 represents the highest number of falling sales in 2 years. And I'm not gonna lie, that is pretty extreme. Now, these numbers are particularly scary as the number of transactions taking place is also much, much higher. 2020 saw about 32% more agreed sales. And according to property websites like Zoopla, that means roughly 100,000 more sales than normal. The higher number of sales and a greater percentage of them now expected to fail means more people are impacted and there's more pressure on those prices. But let's cover how that plays out now. Firstly, that massive increase and rush to buy homes has caused enormous logistical delays. Now, I didn't think of this right off the bat, but it does make a lot of sense. The legal process of buying a house is lengthy in the UK, and at the best of times, it might be 8 to 12 weeks if you're efficient, but that is pretty difficult to meet. And now it can easily be 20 weeks. So in simple terms, it's now taking twice as long to complete the legal process in buying a home. And if you agreed a property towards the end of last year, it's really touch and go whether completion in March is feasible, and thereby that stamp duty holiday that you may have been expecting will end, leaving a hefty tax bill, guys. But hold that thought just for a second though. That second point I wanted to make was the grim economic outlook means that the mortgage market is tightening. Now, we all bank on about those low interest rates and the impact on demand, but the mortgage lending is a risk-based lending itself. By that, I mean banks look at how likely you are to pay back that loan and then approve the loan and agree the rate they're in. The odd thing is the riskier the borrower is seen, the higher the rate. And right now, all lending de facto is riskier with the pandemic conditions. Buyers do go into furlough or are on furlough. Mortgage loans are not really being approved, and so transactions are falling through at the last minute. The demand might be there, yes, but it needs to be executed too. Finally, and I didn't realize quite the extent this would have on the market, is the cladding scandal and the diligence required to ensure external walls are safe following the Grenfell tragedy. That in turn has also left a wave of collapsing sales. And according to the New Build database, an industry analyst, they suggest almost 4.6 million properties are unmortgageable. Is that even a word? But they can't be mortgaged. And that is sheer madness, guys. But what does that all mean for us, right? Well, property experts and our biggest property websites predict approximately half of deals will fail before the March stamp deadline, and missing that deadline will have a meaningful impact on people's pockets, and would expect buyers trying to renegotiate prices down, which is never easy in a normal situation. Now, I do have a few more videos which look at how buoyant the market has been both in the US and the UK last year, and I think they go very well with this video. So I'll link them here for you to check out, and I'll see you over there.